Imagination Studio presents The Secrets of Droon, Books 1 through 3, by Tony Abbott. Read for you by Oliver Wyman. The Hidden Stairs and the Magic Carpet. Chapter 1. The Small Room. Eric Hinkle ran past his mother on his way through the kitchen. He was heading to the back door. "Neil and I are going to play soccer in the yard," he said. "Julie's coming too. Gotta go." "Stop." His mother blocked the door. "Didn't you forget something, Eric?" She held out her hand. She was holding empty garbage bags. Eric looked at his mother. He looked at the garbage bags. All of a sudden, he remembered. "Oh, no. I forgot about the basement." "Knock, knock." Eric sighed. He pulled the door open. Neil Kroger stepped into the kitchen. Neil lived at the end of Eric's street. He was Eric's best friend.
"Hey, what's up?"
Neil asked.
"I have to clean the basement," Eric grumbled.
Mrs. Hinkle gave Eric the garbage bags. "You know, your father wants to start remodeling the basement soon. This was supposed to be your special job." Neil made a face at Eric.
"That doesn't sound like much fun."
"According to my dad, it's not supposed to be fun," Eric replied.
"It's supposed to be done."
"Give it 2 hours," Mrs. Hinkle said. She pointed to the clock. It was 2 o'clock.
2 whole hours?
Eric headed for the basement door.
"Hey, I'll help," said Neil. "We'll be sort of a team. Maybe we'll find some cool stuff."
Eric smiled. Neil is a true friend, he thought. He'll even help clean up junk.
"Okay, come on."
Eric flicked on the light. The two boys tramped down to the basement. On the right side of the stairs was the playroom. It had paneling on the walls, bookcases, a toy chest, a big sofa, and even a television.
"This looks pretty clean," Neil said, peeking in. "If my basement was like this, I'd live down here."
Eric liked the playroom, too. It was a great place to hang out on rainy days.
"The playroom isn't the problem," Eric said. "Look over here."
He stepped into the other side of the basement, the room on the left side of the stairs, the side his father was going to remodel.
"What a mess," Neil said, looking around.
On one wall was a tool bench filled with jars of nails, nuts, and bolts. On another wall were cabinets lined with canned food. An old washer and dryer sat against a third wall. And everywhere in between was junk. In piles, in bunches, in cartons, in boxes. There was even a dusty old chair sitting in the middle of the floor.
"We'd better get started," Eric muttered.
Neil slumped into the old chair.
"We? Did I say I would help?"
Eric stared at his friend.
"You said we were a team." "I'll be the coach," Neil said with a smile. Tap, tap.
A face appeared at the basement window.
"It's Julie," said Eric.
He waved.
"Come in."
Julie Rubin had been friends with Eric and Neil ever since they got stuck in a tree together in kindergarten. Since then, they'd been in all the same classes. They even went to the same summer camp.
"Hi,"
Julie said as she raced down the stairs. She held a soccer ball under her arm.
"I thought we were going to play,"
she said, checking her watch.
"It's only 2 o'clock.
Eric dragged a big toy box out from under the stairs.
"Sorry, I've got to clean all this stuff up."
"And I'm coaching,"
Neil said.
"Ball, please?"
Julie passed the ball to Neil and looked around.
"It looks like a big job. I'll help."
"How about a little game first?"
Neil said. He stood up and bounced the ball once. Then he swung his foot hard.
"Heads up, everybody!"
"Wait!"
Eric yelled, ducking behind the box. Too late. The ball was already in the air. It bounced off the tool bench and smacked Neil right in the face.
"Ow! My nose!"
"Serves you right," said Julie.
The ball bounced off the washing machine and rolled into the shadows by the stairs.
I'll get it.
Julie jumped after the ball, then stopped.
Hey, what's this?
She pointed to a door in the wall under the stairs. It was open slightly.
My house has that too, Neil said. There's a cool little closet inside.
Eric remembered seeing that door a million times, but he had never been inside.
It must have swung open when I pulled that box away.
Well, I think the ball went in there,
Julie said. She swung the door open further.
Cool.
Inside was a small closet. The ceiling was the underside of the basement stairs. It slanted all the way to the floor at the back of the room. In the center sat the soccer ball.
This is great,
Eric said, peeking over Julie's shoulder.
We can put some of the junk in here.
Julie stepped into the room and reached for the ball.
It's an awesome secret hideout.
Let me see,
Neil said. He jumped over to Eric, accidentally pushing him into the door.
Blam!
It slammed shut. A muffled scream came from inside the room.
Help!
Cried Julie.
I'm falling!
Chapter 2. The Sky Below the Ground. Eric pulled the door open quickly. Julie was standing in the middle of the tiny room. She was staring at the floor beneath her feet. The ball was nowhere in sight.
Are you okay?
Eric asked. Julie pushed her way quickly out of the room.
The ball went down there.
Eric and Neil looked at the gray cement floor. Then they looked back at Julie.
There were steps, Julie said, and I almost fell all the way down.
Steps? Said Neil. Where the floor is?
Julie nodded.
And the soccer ball went bouncing down them. Then you opened the door, and the steps sort of disappeared.
Eric and Neil entered the little room under the stairs. Then Julie stepped back in. They stood close together.
Maybe the ball whacked you in the head, Julie, Neil said with a laugh. You just thought there were stairs.
Eric looked down at the floor. There weren't any steps anywhere.
Julie, I don't think... I'm not making this up,
she said.
Wait, the door was closed, and it was dark at first. Maybe then...
It's pretty dark already, Neil said.
Don't close the door on us.
Slam! Julie did close the door on them. Neil grumbled.
Now it's very dark.
Then, suddenly, it wasn't. The floor began to shimmer beneath them, and a bright light glowed under their feet. Then, whoosh, a stairway appeared out of nowhere. A set of steps leading down, leading away from the basement, away from the house.
Whoa,
Eric said.
It looks like outside down there. Is this what you saw?
Julie nodded.
Told you.
The steps glowed a rainbow of colors. Julie peered over Eric's shoulder.
Let's go find the ball.
Neil reached for the door.
I don't think so.
Come on, said Eric.
He wasn't sure why, but he felt as if they had to go. He stepped down to the next step, then to the next and the next. Already the air was brighter where he was. It was pink and cool and fresh.
Neil? Julie? This is incredible,
Eric said.
We have to go down.
I don't think this is such a good idea, Neil said.
Julie laughed. She ran to catch up with Eric.
The air smells so sweet. Hurry up, Neil. We're already 10 steps ahead of you.
Just below them was a forest of tall trees. The stairs led all the way down to the treetops.
Unbelievable,
Eric whispered.
Do you think this is some kind of magic?
There's no such thing as magic,
Julie said, biting her lip. She always did that when she didn't understand why things were happening.
But this place is beautiful. Strange, too. It's sort of like a...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.